Hello, my dear students and my dear friends. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to Top Lesson for you. Dear friends, as we are discussing about the blood supply of the lower limbs, right? So before this lecture, as you know, I have recorded about the blood supply of the male and female pelvis. You can go and watch those lectures also to know about the branches of the common iliac artery, the internal iliac artery and the external iliac artery we are going to discuss right now. Right, so this external iliac artery leads down to the lower limb. We will see all those branches in a clear way, in a very understandable way. So you have to be with us, and if you are watching us for the first time, you can watch our previous lectures regarding many viscerals and different parts of the human body. And it's a humble request that if you are watching us for the first time, so please subscribe our channel and please share our videos with your friends also, right? So friends, let's discuss our lecture regarding the blood supply of the lower limb. So let me remind you a little bit about this diagram that what we have drawn there. Friends, as you can see, this is the abdominal aorta. Right, abdominal aorta, clear friends. Now this abdominal aorta bifurcates into a right and a left common iliac arteries. I have discussed it before also. Let me mention them once again here. This is, as this is on the right side, so I will mention it as right common iliac artery. Clear friends? So this one is our right common iliac artery and this one is our left common iliac artery. Okay. Now this right common iliac artery, either left common iliac artery, when it goes further forward, right, it gives off two branches, this one and this one. So this one which goes internally, this is called internal iliac artery, internal iliac artery, right, and this one is our external iliac artery, external iliac artery, right. We are concerned, in this video, we are concerned with this artery. What are its branches and what does it do there? Right, this internal iliac artery and its branches are completely discussed in my previous lectures. You can watch them also, right? So let us see this external iliac artery and its branches up to here. As from here downward, it becomes the femoral artery. So from here up to here, this artery is called the external iliac artery, and let's see its branches and its dimensions, right? So let me discuss here the external iliac artery and its branches. What is external iliac artery? So we can define external iliac artery as when the common iliac artery bifurcates, it gives off an external iliac artery and an internal iliac artery. So what is external iliac artery? It is the branch of the common iliac artery either on the right side or on the left side. So we can define it as the common iliac artery, the common iliac artery bifurcates, yeah, we know it, it bifurcates here, right, at the pelvic brim. I will show you now what is meant by pelvic brim. At level of sacroiliac joint, right? To give external iliac artery. Right, friends. So look carefully. What are the main points to remember? The pelvic brim at level of sacroiliac joint, external iliac artery. Right? Look carefully. Let me show you here. Friends, this is our, right? This is our iliac bone, pubic bone, right? This is the ilium, and this is the, these are the sacral vertebrae, right? Sacral vertebrae in the coccygeal sacral. So this joint is called the sacroiliac joint, right? This joint is called the sacroiliac joint, and this rounded part is called the pelvic brim, right? This is called the pelvic brim. So the common iliac artery, right? The common iliac artery gives off here two branches at the level of the pelvic brim, at the level of the sacroiliac joint. It gives off an external iliac artery and an internal iliac artery. So the point of origin of external iliac artery is the pelvic brim, right, at the level of sacroiliac joint. Right, friends, it's done. Next, so from where does this artery arise? What is its origin? I have told you here that at the pelvic brim, at the level of sacroiliac joint, right? What is the diameter of this artery? Diameter of this artery. So the diameter of this artery is about 1.5 centimeter. It has a diameter of 1.5 centimeter. And what is the length of this artery? Length. So its length is about 2.5 inches. 2.5 inches. Dear friends, from here, from the point of origin up to the point where it gives then the femoral artery, this we have made a very large diagram, but exactly and the really is not as long as I have drawn here, right? So from the point of origin up to here, up to the last point, it is about 2.5 inches. It is its length. Now let me show you the branches of this artery. What are the branches of the external iliac artery? Clear, friends? So the first branch that this artery gives is the deep circumflex artery. That is the deep circumflex artery. And what is the deep circumflex artery? Where is that? Look, let us come here. Look at this artery. This is the external iliac artery, and it is its first branch, right? So this first branch is called the deep circumflex artery, right? Let me name it here. This one is the deep circumflex artery. Done, friends. What does it do? Which parts of the body, which muscles does it supply? So the deep circumflex artery is responsible to supply blood. It gives some little branches to the anterior abdominal wall muscles, right? And it also supplies the iliac crest, right? This is our iliac crest. This is iliac bone and this is its crest. So it supplies blood to anterior abdominal wall, right, and iliac crest. Right, friends. And the next branch, the second branch which this artery gives, is the superficial circumflex artery. Superficial circumflex artery. Right. So where is that artery? Let's come here. This is our second branch. You can see this branch. So this is the superficial circumflex artery. It means it also here. That is the superficial circumflex artery. Done. This artery is responsible to supply blood to the inguinal lymph nodes. Right? I'm writing it. It's blood supply. Starting with green color. It is responsible to supply blood to the inguinal lymph nodes. Inguinal lymph nodes. Right. Then there is a third branch from this external iliac artery, and that is the inferior epigastric artery, right? That is inferior epigastric artery. Very good. So this inferior epigastric artery is this artery. Look, this branch bifurcates from here, detaches from here, and goes superiorly, right? And then at this point, right, it anastomoses with the superior epigastric artery, right, which comes from the internal thoracic artery. Then it goes down and it makes the superior epigastric artery. So this inferior epigastric artery goes and makes anastomosis with that superior epigastric artery, right, friends? So this inferior epigastric artery is responsible to supply blood to the anterior abdominal wall. It supplies blood to anterior abdominal wall, right? And next, it is responsible to supply blood to umbilical region. Umbilical region. Right, friends? Okay, so what did we say up to now? The first branch is called the deep circumflex artery. The second branch is called the superficial circumflex artery. The third branch is called, this one, let me name it here. This is called the inferior epigastric artery. Inferior epigastric artery. Right? Okay, then the fourth branch is called the superficial epigastric artery. Epigastric artery. Right. Let me name it also here. This one is called the, this is our fourth branch, right? So this one is called superficial. Epigastric artery, right, friends? The fourth. What does this artery supplies? It supplies most parts of the anterior abdominal wall, right? So it supplies anterior abdominal wall, right? This here is the fifth branch from this external iliac artery. And the fifth branch is called the chemostatic artery. Chemostatic branch. Friends, let me tell you that this chemostatic branch is present only in males, not in females, right? So chemostatic branch is this one. Look, you can see here, this artery is called the, as I have not space here, I have made it a little shorter. It goes further forward to the chemostatic muscle, right? To the chemostatic muscle below the spermatic cord, right? So this artery is present only in males, right? This is called chemostatic branch, and it supplies blood to the chemostatic muscle. Supply blood to chemostatic muscle, which is present below spermatic cord, right, friends? So this was the fifth branch. The sixth branch from this artery, which is present in females, right? The sixth branch, which is called the artery of the round ligament, right? Let me write it here as artery of round ligament. Right, friends? This artery is present only in females. Okay, let me tell you, this is our sixth branch, right, friends? And this branch is called the artery of round ligament. Artery of round ligament. Okay, this branch is present in females. It supplies blood to the round ligament of the uterus, as the men do not have the uterus. That's why this artery is absent in men, right? So it supplies blood to the round ligament of uterus, right, friends? So there is the sixth one, and the last branch of this artery, this external iliac artery, the seventh one, is called the femoral artery, which we will discuss further. Femoral artery, and this is the main artery which is responsible to supply blood to the lower limbs, right, friends? So these seven branches are the branches of the external iliac artery. Let us recap fastly this external iliac artery. What is external iliac artery? It is the artery which arises at the bifurcation of the common iliac artery at the pelvic brim at the level of the sacroiliac joint. I have mentioned it before. What is its diameter? It's about 1.5 centimeter in diameter, and its length is about 2.5 inches. And what are the branches from it? So there are about seven branches from this external iliac artery. The first one here we have is the deep circumflex artery, right? What does it supply? I have written here, right? Then there is the superficial circumflex artery, and what does it do? I have written here. Then there is the third one, is called the inferior epigastric artery, right? And the fourth one is called the superficial epigastric artery. The fifth one is called the chemostatic artery, and the sixth one is called the artery of round ligament, which is present in female only. And the seventh artery, look here, this one, which is a branch of this external iliac artery, moving further down, this is called the femoral artery. So let me mention this artery with this red color. This point is called the femoral artery, and it goes further down and gives next branches, which will lead to the blood supply of the lower limb. That will be seen in the next lecture, in the next video. So be with us, don't go anywhere to watch the full lecture regarding the blood supply of the lower limb. Okay, so till then, bye-bye.